Adobe just announced commerce as a service. If five syllables weren't enough, four more just got added.
It's really beyond words.
This seemingly simple addition as a service solves Magento 2's biggest pain points: complex upgrades, security concerns, and site performance. Might this be Magento 3? I have the inside track for you condensed into this non-biased, brief, jargon-free video, and at the end, I'll share what this means for merchants currently using Adobe Commerce who are understandably leery of yet another costly upgrade. So here we go. So you're probably familiar with Adobe Commerce's cloud offering. Magento 2 is hosted on Adobe servers. You upload your code to their servers, and you see the results on both the front end, the customer experience side, or the back end, the admin panel. This new commerce as a service offering is Magento 2, but with one small change. The code now resides in a black box, which means Adobe manages it for you, much like Shopify manages it for their customers. You can't change it. There is no longer also a need to browse the database or tweak the code. What in the world? Magento has always been about customization. It's literally turning into a Shopify. I know. This is a change, perhaps even a dramatic change. But here's the thing. Instead of eliminating customization, Adobe is simply changing how it happens. And in many ways, this new approach actually makes development easier and more scalable. Let's talk about several implications. Number one, commerce as a service is completely headless. The browsable customer experience is an entirely separate website and code base. There is no more Luma, and Hoover will not work with this either. You can, though, use the front-end experience provided by Adobe or bring your own. This will mean faster deployments, much less to break, and I promise a far smaller learning curve. Number two, Adobe entirely controls the code and the infrastructure. There's no more painful upgrades, no more security concerns, infinite speed. The result is essentially a dramatic reduction in your risk as you're not hosting this beast anymore. And number three, because of this control, Adobe is actually promising to begin development again on the core. They can now iterate quickly with the promise that there will be no breaking changes. I understand that they're anticipating having weekly feature releases. So while commerce as a service is not Magento 3, it is the pathway to drastic but backwards compatible transformation of the Magento application. So in essence, it's not Magento 3, but it is the pathway to Magento 3. The result is an entirely different development process. So while the application under the covers remains pretty much the same, it will feel like a new system altogether. However, the good news is the industry has been coalescing around this style of development for several years now. Now to the question that I know you've been wanting to ask since the beginning of this video. Why do you put out videos like this? I'm just kidding. This is actually the approach we take with all of our clients. It's highly consultative and educational to help you find solutions that will fuel your business goals. In fact, we host a monthly Magento Ask Me Anything for merchants with some of the incredible folks on our team. Link is here, right here, to get your exclusive invite. Again, only for merchants. But what you really wanted to know was, how can I actually still customize Magento? First, instead of putting your changes in the same code system as Magento, they're just going to be pulled into a separate system called App Builder. App Builder can modify your admin panel, it can listen to webhooks, and it can add extra functionality. You might be saying, but I'm a merchant, and I have not ever heard of App Builder. Why is that? All I can say is change is really hard, and Swift Order can help you, because unfortunately, very few agencies are staying ahead of the radical transformation that Adobe is bringing to the table. But second, instead of modules that you would purchase from Amnesty or Headworks or any one of these other places, they are now called apps, and they come from Adobe Exchange. These actually run on App Builder as well. And third, this new approach is headless, meaning the front end is an entirely separate website and it is open source. There is no limits to what you can do here. So combined with App Builder powering the back end business logic, you literally have just about the same flexibility as you did with the old Magento system. Only now the blast radius for security vulnerabilities and even performance problems is significantly less. But I can see you still pushing back and saying, but what if I want to deeply customize how a particular area behaves? For example, I don't want an order to be placed immediately, and I want to kind of create a pseudo cart after the order was placed. I get it. With Magento, it's always been possible. And now with this black box idea, it kind of seems like it isn't. But here's the thing. At the most basic level, an e-commerce platform is just really a big database with a API or a way for other programs to communicate in. Even Shopify and BigCommerce also operate the same way, which means you can create custom processes that still modify how things work. You just have to approach it differently than before. And in some cases, more work can be involved, but often it's the same amount of work or potentially even less work, again, with the benefit of a smaller blast radius for security concerns. But remember, the only tiny change is that Adobe is making that source code no longer available. In my experience, though, they are going out of their way to retain almost every extension point. Now, there's going to be two groups of you watching this video. Either you're already using Adobe Commerce or you are considering it. As I said at the beginning of the video, we are going to address those of you who are on Adobe Commerce. And here's what I want to tell you. Right now, if you are on Adobe Commerce, there is nothing to change or even to consider. Well, except for one thing, your agency partner, like, well, what we do at Swift Otter, should be leveraging React for building major front-end customizations to be forward or future compatible, and App Builder for new features. Again, if you need a team that is experienced with this type of development, that's us here at Swift Otter. Not worried about Adobe dropping support for your current e-commerce configuration. In other words, Magento 2 even hosted on Adobe's cloud services. I'm not worried about that. Remember years ago when they said they would not keep supporting the Luma theme? It's still here. It's been kept up to date. No new features, no improvements, but it's here and it still pretty much works. Adobe stresses that their support for existing e-commerce configurations, it's not going to change. However, if you are considering moving to Adobe Commerce, we should discuss how its pros and cons pertain to your brand. Adobe Commerce is not right for everyone, but it is a slam dunk when it is. And that's honestly too much to fit into this video looking at the pros and cons. So that will be discussed in a forthcoming video. What I can say is if you are going with the paid version, I would unbelievably strongly discourage you from ever launching a new website using this old open source methodology. Go with Commerce as a service. Don't even consider this open source route as it will eventually be discontinued. Not for many years now, but you really want a platform that's going to grow with you and not have a deadline, even if it's far into the future. I hope you found this overview helpful. If you're a merchant, you have further questions about how this affects you, please email me at joseph@swiftotter.com. If we don't know the answer, we know where to get it. And we would love the opportunity to support you in your quest to conquer goals and to exceed expectations.